Rudy Giuliani filing for Chapter 11 bankruptcy in New York. He's listing debts of up to $500 million, assets of up to just $10 million.
I thought it was go woke, go broke, but apparently it's go joke and go broke. Rudy Giuliani has filed for bankruptcy after a jury in Washington ordered him to pay a whopping $148 million in damages to two Fulton County, Georgia election workers whom he defamed following the 2020 presidential election. Now, oftentimes when we hear of public figures or corporations filing for bankruptcy, it's an effort to hide assets and avoid paying the legal liabilities that they've been told to pay. But in this case, I actually do think that Rudy Giuliani has squandered the incredible wealth he had built for himself as a successful lawyer. So let's get to the details. The bankruptcy filing in New York came after a court ordered that Giuliani must immediately pay $146 million of what he owes to the former election workers, Ruby Freeman and Wandrea Shaye Moss. Now, the filing shows that in addition to the Freeman and Moss judgment, Giuliani also owes quite a bit in taxes, a whopping $1 million in federal and state taxes. Now, he also owes millions of dollars in unpaid legal fees as well, something that we've shared on the show in previous stories. Now, just quickly going back to the judgment in the defamation case, I mentioned that he was ordered to pay $148 million in damages, but that he was later ordered to immediately pay $146 million. That's because the judge had reduced the verdict by about $2 million to reflect the damages the pair were paid in a settlement last year with the other defendant in the case, the TV network OAN. Okay. So with that said, a spokesperson for Rudy Giuliani says that the former mayor's bankruptcy filings should not really come as a surprise to anyone. And he might really be right about that, because we've been hearing about Giuliani's financial problems for quite some time now. Ted Goodman, who is his spokesperson, says no person could have reasonably believed that Mayor Rudy Giuliani would be able to pay such a high punitive amount. Chapter 11 will afford Mayor Giuliani the opportunity and time to pursue an appeal while providing transparency for his finances under the supervision of bankruptcy court to ensure all creditors are treated equally and fairly throughout the process. But what's also really interesting is if he thinks that he can easily skirt the damages he is ordered to pay the two election workers he defamed, he's got another thing coming. So let's go to the next video and you'll know exactly what I'm talking about.
Here's the thing about this $148 million judgment. It is likely not dischargeable in bankruptcy because it resulted from willful and malicious acts, which are not subject to bankruptcy protection. So whatever happens with this reorganization and the bankruptcy, this judgment will stay with him for the rest of his life. Now, he can appeal it, but the judge in imposing the judgment yesterday made clear that in order to appeal, he's gonna have to put up a bond, essentially equivalent to the amount, to the $148 million, which clearly he does not have. So an appeal seems rather remote at this point.
Now, Freeman and Moss had a feeling that he was going to file for bankruptcy and try to avoid paying what he has been ordered to pay. And so they successfully got the judge involved in doing something about that concern. And that's what was referred to in the video you just watched. The judge who presided over Freeman and Moss's defamation case lifted a 30-day pause on the judgment on Wednesday after the mother and daughter said that they were concerned that he tried to hide his assets. So the judge said, quote, Giuliani's failure to satisfy even more modest monetary awards entered earlier in this case provides good cause to believe that he will seek to dissipate or conceal his assets during the 30-day period. U.S. District Judge Beryl Howell wrote in her order, the decision allowed Freeman and Moss to go after Giuliani's assets in New York and Florida. And as you all know, we've also shared in the past that Giuliani has had his New York City apartment on the market for quite some time now. He's trying to sell it for $6 million, but he's having a difficult time selling it. So I believe those are some of the assets that they're referring to in this decision. Cenk.
Yeah, so we were led to believe that Giuliani didn't have anything left. Oh, all of a sudden it turns out you got $10 million in assets. All right, well, they'll take that. And they talked about how they're gonna go for his houses in Florida and New York. Yeah, they're owed that money, and that's how it works. So I'm a little surprised that he can't appeal because of the rule that that expert just explained. I'm not sure that I think that that's a good idea, but whether I think it's a good idea or not, apparently he can't appeal. So he's toast. He can't discharge it and he can't appeal. Yeah, that's an albatross around his neck for the rest of his life. And so they got some protections in bankruptcy, and you might be able to keep one of your houses, etc. OJ got away with keeping some stuff, but yeah, this is going to, at a bare minimum, haunt him. He's not going to be able to accumulate any money anymore, and so this is what happens. And that gets to the most important point, which is, you know, a lot of us looked at these guys telling outrageous lies about how they had all this evidence that the election was stolen by Hugo Chavez or a Kraken or a mule or something along those lines. And we all thought, like, are they just gonna get away with this? These are outrageous lies. Not anywhere near true, and they're saying it all over TV. And it did, it tricked like 40% of the country to this day into thinking that the election was stolen. Well, it turns out there are consequences. And you know, just that little bit of justice to me goes a long, long way. I'm agreed. Thrilled at the result here. So it turns out, no, you can't just lie on TV. No, you can't just smear people and get away with it. These are gonna be the consequences. So Republicans or whoever you are out there, you wanna smear people and you wanna defame them and you wanna lie about them and you wanna spread outrageous lies for political reasons, well, look around your house and see if you like the house and the things in it, because one day somebody's gonna come take that from you for all the damage that you have done this country.
Exactly. And Cenk, I hear you about the decision by the judge to make it incredibly difficult for him to appeal the decision. But I also want to just remind everyone that immediately after he was ordered to pay that insanely high amount in damages, he then went on to Newsmax and proceeded to continue defaming the two election workers. And so they filed a second defamation lawsuit against him. They're not asking for any damages. They're just trying to get him to shut up. But he's his own worst enemy. He's just like Trump. They're two peas in a pod. So he's gonna continue getting himself into trouble, even as he's facing, you know, all of this financial harm as a result.
This is what happens to everyone who trusts Trump. You thought that he was gonna take care of you, Rudy? No, he didn't pay your legal bills. He didn't do anything for you, and he just ruined your life. And is he coming back around to help you now? No, of course not, because that's who Donald Trump is. He doesn't care about anybody but himself. So just keep staying in his corner, see how it turns out for you. Because based on now, the criminal trials are next. So forget being bankrupt, he might be going to jail soon.
Thanks for watching the video, guys. We also love it if you hit the join button below, because that makes you a member, and members allow us to be independent, honest. We could be as progressive as we want, no corporate media influence, and that's all because of you guys. We love doing the show with our members. Hit the join button, become one of the Young Turks.